why Ford would be happy with merging the Fusion, in light of the arrangement to move generation to China, alongside Ford's announcement it won't import Fusions to the US from China. The article addressed three reasons for its fair-sized car has a superior possibility of justifying a gravestone than a people to come. Of the reasons given, hybrids, efficiency, and longer car credits, one sounds good to us, one influences us to ponder what may have been, one influences us to ponder what's coming. We likewise need to charge the privileged perpetrators for the Fusion's passing. Portage is an associate, however by all account not the only hatchet man. Our take. Crossover. It's likely time to drop the contingent tense and acknowledge the Fusion's coming flatline, particularly since Ford CEO Jim Hackett stated, "I'm giving you an indication it's a goner." The Fusion's on its back wheels in the Coliseum, draining 5 watts minus 20 into the sand as it's hacked to pieces by tag group Butter's crossover and SUV, while a foaming auto purchasing open shakes the stands yelling. Crossovers? Michael Martinez writes in his piece, although, the Fusion is, still cheaper than base Escape or Edge crossover, longer loan terms have made the difference and many buyers' monthly payments hardly noticeable. There's the worrying one. We consumers have made it useful for automakers and banks to create ways for us to purchase larger, heavier, thirstier, more expensive vehicles on what appear to be similar terms to those we once used to own smaller, lighter, more fuel-efficient, less expensive vehicles. The modern terms are in the sand, though, and consumers are stretching themselves worryingly thin to meet